Today, I am going to discuss about parallelogram and also rhombus. Now, already we have done the problem of parallelograms. Now, today, specialist will start rhombus. Now, the theorem is that, prove that the diagonals of the rhombus bisect each other perpendicularly. The diagonals of the rhombus bisect each other perpendicularly. Prove that the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other perpendicularly. Perpendicularly bisect each other. Prove that the diagonals of a rhombus perpendicularly bisect each other. Now, we draw a rhombus. Now, what is rhombus and what is square? You see here, note here, two figures like as a parallelogram and rectangle, two types are very close, and the rhombus and the what? Square. That means four sides of the quadrilateral, whose four sides equal, is called a square. In the rhombus also, four sides is equal. But each and every angle is 90 degree for square, but for rhombus, this is not. So, the figure of the rhombus ABCD is a rhombus. Its two diagonals meet at point O. Now we start as a language left A B C D is a rhombus. It is required to prove that diagonals perpendicular bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other perpendicularly. Bisect each other perpendicularly. No? Now, no need to construction, just we can say two diagonals meet off. Let two diagonals meet at O. Two diagonals meet at O. No? Now we start. ABC, ABCD is a rhombus. It is required to prove that diagonals bisect each other perpendicularly. Let two diagonals meet at O. From the two triangles, from triangle that and that, sometimes we take, you see here, already we proved that such type of projection already we discussed. Sometimes we take from that and that. And in that case, why you take that and that? Now, it have to stay on your mind the two angles that will bisect each other perpendicularly means its nearest angle should be 180. Otherwise, it is not possible to prove that the it will be 90 degree. So, if we take that and that, no relation, that angle to that angle, not just it will be the vertical, but there is in between there is some space blank. So if we take this one, then when we add, then we will get a straight angle. So from A B O A B O and triangle AOD we have, you see here, AB equal to AD, AB equal to AD, first thing, AB equal to AD, number one, because all sides are equal. All sides are equal. All sides are equal. All sides are equal. Again, you see here, that side equal to that side, S rhombus X as a what? Parallelogram. Rhombus is also considered as a parallelogram. As the parallelogram, we have diagonals bisect each other. So, rhombus here, this rhombus, we consider it is a parallelogram. So, we can write as DO equal to DO, but we have to mention rhombus is also a parallelogram. BO equal to DO. Rhombus is also a parallelogram. Rhombus is also a parallelogram. and then that is the common side. That is the what? Common side means AO equal to AO common side. Common side. Which are required for the congruency of the two triangles. Means, for making the congruency of the two triangles, already we have angle S, angle number 1, then S, A, S, or S, 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 like this. Like this. As it satisfied, side, as it satisfied, that postulate is, otherwise you don't write here, don't mention it, just CK is equal, which satisfy these ones. It is here, side, satisfied, in some other cases, it is satisfied, any one of the postulate is satisfied, then it is a what? Congruence of the two triangles. So we can write here. Therefore, this triangle congruence, that one, triangle AO, AB, AB, O, congruence means that side, congruence, triangle what, AO, D, AB, O, this triangle congruence to AO, D, O, AB, O. So, two triangles are congruence. Now we can write, then we can say that this side equal to what? That side, and this side equal to that side, and this angle equal to that angle. Like angles or like sides are equal. So this angle equal to that angle, this angle we can write as AOB, as it is a congruence. Therefore, angle AOB equal to angle A or B. This angle equal to that angle. Now we proceed. But when we join these two lines, then it will have straight angle. Then it will have straight angle. So we can write here AOB plus AOD equal to 180 degrees. That's because straight angle. Straight angle. This equal to 180. We proceed like as AOB, AOB means what? AOB means AOD. AOB means what? AOB means AOB. So, for AOB we can write as AOD. AOD plus again AOD equal to 180 degree to AOD equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle AOD equal to 180 degree by 2, that is 90 degree. AOD means what? 90 degree. AOD means what? 90 degree. You see here. AOD means what? 90. If it is 90, as this equal to that, so that also what? 90. So we can write as, therefore, AOD 90 means what? AOB also 90. AOB also 90. Now, so that also 90, that also 90. Similarly, you can prove that that also 90, that also 90. So one line we have to write. Similarly, you can prove. Similarly. Similarly, we can prove that B or C equal to 90 and C or D equal to 90. B or C equal to C or D equal to 90. Each end of the angles are 90. Now you see. Already this part equal to that part as rhombus X like as a parallelogram. This equal to that. It is already proved. And each and every angles are 90. That means the diagonals of the rhombus perpendicularly bisect each other. Perpendicularly bisect each other. Therefore, the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other perpendicularly. Bisect each other perpendicularly. This sign is perpendicular. Perpendicularly. You have to write in spelling. Now, I want to show you geometry. This is for both class 8 and 9. For 8, you search at in your book or in every book, there should be the chapter like as the quadrilateral, parallelogram, rectangle, as well as rhombus. In that chapter you will get this portion. And as a class 9 exercise number, example exercise 8.1, you will get all the parts. And first one is the theorem. Now, next problem, ABCD is a parallelogram or a rectangle. In most books, it is mentioned as a parallelogram, and some books it is mentioned as a rectangle. But it will be same as because rectangle acts as a parallelogram. Originally, it should be parallelogram. So, ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. I write like this. You have to write in spelling. ABCD is a parallelogram. In some books it is written as rectangle. In some book it is write as a rectangle. ABCD is a parallelogram and AP and CQ are perpendicular. AP and CQ are perpendicular from vertices A and C A and C on. A and C on BD. On diagonal BD. On diagonal BD. On diagonal BD. Then prove that number one triangle APB APB congruent triangle APB congruent what? Triangle CQD. And also AP equal to CQ. AP equal to CQ. AP equal to CQ. You see here. ABCD is a parallelogram of a rectangle. And AP and CQ are perpendicular from vertices A and C. Vertices A and C on diagonal BD. On diagonal what? BD. Prove that triangle APB congruent triangle CQD. And AP equal to CQ. Now we have to draw the diagram. First we draw here and then we will take that means rub the board. Suppose like this. It is A B C D. ABCD is a parallelogram. AP and CQ are perpendicular from vertices A and C. From vertices A and C, we have to draw what? AP and CQ on the diagonal BD. Diagonal BD. Now from A we'll draw AP like this, and from C we'll draw CQ. It is Q, it is P. Huh? Then we have to prove that APB means what? APB, that triangle congruent. That triangle means CQD. Now we have to prove that that congruent that and AP that equal to CQ. That we have to prove. So you see here. Otherwise, if A is taken in the that side, there is no problem. Like as I take here A, B, C, D. Then on what diagonal? BD. Diagonal BD. BD is higher. That. In that case, you draw A, P means like as AP. And CQ like this. No problem. Then we have to prove that ABP means what? ABP. That equal to that. From these two triangles. No any problems. The figure maybe you will be puzzled by thinking that sometimes any sir have taken here A, B, C, D. But in any other background, they will take here A, B, C, D. A may be here, but there is no problem. Just you have to try. You try to understand their figure and on fire. According to that question, you have to draw the figure. Then it will be okay. Now we write this diagram. A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D, and B, D, on the B, D diagonal, we draw perpendicular, what? A, P, and from C, we draw perpendicular, A, Q, C, Q, huh? CQ. According to question what? From the radius A and C. From the radius A and C. We draw AP perpendicular and CQ perpendicular on BD diagonal. On diagonal BD. Now solution, you see here, already no need to explain the diagram language, just you write the properly, no, and now you take directly from the two triangles, that and that, that and that means what, triangle, APB, APB and other is what? CQD, CQD. From the two triangles. Now, from triangle, what triangle? APB and triangle CQ. D, we have you see here. We have to make these two triangles congruent. We have to make these two triangles what? Congruent. Now for congruency, we have to show three factors like as A, S, A, S, 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 A, S, like this. Three factors, any one of that? No, this. Others also are not. Now, we proceed from these two triangles, you see here, from this triangle and this triangle. You see, now, that side equal to that side means AB equal to CD by DC. A, B equal to what? CD, number one. Because as it is a parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel or equal. As it is parallelogram. From the definition, parallelogram, opposite sides are equal and parallel. It is number one. Next one, that angle equal to that angle. Because perpendicular don't AP and CQ on BD. Perpendicular don't means 90 degree. So we can write here, A, B, D equal to what? C, Q, D. Number two, 90 degree. Perpendicular means what? 90 degree. Two factors, what? Side and angle gone. Side and angle gone. Suppose, any other side of angle, Now you see here this parallel back. That means this parallel back. A, B, C, D. AB parallel CD or DC. Transversal that one. Transversal that one. So we can write as that angle equal to that angle, that one. No, just we can write as that angle equal to that angle, alternate angle. No need to mention. So, first case we have to write as angle A, B, P. A, B, P. Or A, B, B, same thing. A, B, P. We have considered the triangle A, B, P. But in that case, A, B, B. Same thing, just the side is extended, angle is same. A, B, P equal to angle C, D, Q. C, D, Q. What answer is that number 3? Alternate angle. Alternate angle. Alternate. Alternate angle. Now you satisfy what? Side angle and side. Side angle and angle. Side angle and angle means what? Side angle and angle. Side angle and angle. This satisfies the first one. So, triangle 5, ABP, ABP, ABP congruence, triangle CQD, CQD, no? As these two triangles are congruence, so we can write as AP, no? AP, that equal to CQ, because this congruence that you see here whose triangles are congruence here, that one. That one, this one. Another is what? That one. If we write separately, this triangle A, B, P, and this triangle is what? B, C, Q. So, if these two triangles congruence, then that equal to that. And this is the common PQ. No, if you extend Q, then it will become B. Here is Q. Extend B. So this is the common. And AP equal to what? QA. That equal to that one. No need to explain more. So AP equal to CQ. Hence proof. You think here geometry means you have to apply your knowledge properly and you don't neglect its previous chapter. Gradually you should do the chapter, then all will appear to easy. Next chapter. Next question. In parallelogram ABCD, two points P and Q are taken on diagonal BD. In parallelogram ABCD, in parallelogram A B C D in parallelogram A B C D, two points P and Q, two points P and Q, P and Q are taken on diagonal BD, on diagonal BD, such that DP equal to what? DQ, DP equal to BQ, DP equal to BQ, such that DP equal to BQ, so that number one, what have to sum? Triangle, what triangle? APD, APD, APD congruent triangle, APD congruent triangle, CQB, CQB, CQB. Number two, AP equal to CQ, AP equal to CQ, AP equal to what? CQ, AP equal to CQ. Now you say parallelogram ABCD. Parallelogram ABCD. Here we can write here A, B, C, D. And diagonal is what? BD. Diagonal is what? BD. We take P and Q. P and Q are taken on diagonal BD such that DP, DP, and we have taken Q. This Q what? DP equal to BQ. Here Q. That means DP equal to BQ. Understand? This BD we take two points P and Q such that person is equal to that person. Now DP equal to BQ. DP equal to BQ. That prove that, what have to prove? APD. APD. APD means what? AP, this one. APD. That one. APD equal to CQB. CQB means what? CQB. Triangles have to be congruent and AP equal to CQ. So we join AP. AP means what? AP equal to CQ also equal to that equal to that. Actually, no need to join others, but we join this one as in your book it is given. Now you see here. Already you draw the figure properly, then just now there you do that one. No need to write here like theorems, just from the two triangles APD, APD and CQB, CQB, from two triangles. A, P, D, N, triangle C, Q, D. We have, you see here, first one, that and that, from that triangle and that triangle. From that triangle and that triangle, very easy one, you see here. Many students are face difficult geometry because they have no idea to know. They do not try to know these facts. So it feels difficult for them. Actually, geometry is much more easier than that of the maths. And what have to do, though the course is hard, but teachers should learn you, should teach you. So, everyone pay to the board and try to understand from these two triangles. From these two triangles, that angle equal to that angle, alternate. That and that triangle, that angle equal to that angle, because it is a parallelogram, this parallel, that transversal, so that angle equal to that angle. Number one, that is what? ADP. ADP equal to what? CBQ. CBQ. Alternate, number one, alternate angle, that angle, alternate angle, number one case, angle equal to angle gone. Now another, you see here, that side equal to that side. That side equal to that side because opposite sides of parallelogram. That means AD. AD equal to what? BC. Opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram. And next one you see here. That person equal to that person already given. That person equal to that person. So we can write as TD. PD. PD equal to what? BQ. Given. Given means given in question. Now you see here side angle. Angle. Side, that means we can write as side angle side. It postulates. Therefore, triangle APD, triangle APD, APD congruent, triangle CQB, APD. Congruence CQB triangle CQB. You see here as this means what? That. And this means what? That. So that equal to that. That equal to that. Then, and this equal to already that one. So we can have to prove last one AP. AP. So this side. As it is the including this triangle and this side AP, then CQ means also within this triangle. So we can write as number two AP equal to C. Q and proof. Hence proof. This sum already done for the class 8, now for class 9. You see here, angles of a quadrilateral are in the ratio. Angles of a quadrilateral. Angles of a quadrilateral are in the ratio. Are in the ratio 3:2, 5:2, 3:2, 5:2, 9:2, 13. 3:2, 5:2, 9:2, 13. Then find all the angles. Then find all the angles of the quadrilateral. Last one. Quadrilaterals, the angles, where the angles are given in the ratio, then we have to consider. Let the actual measures of the angles are. Let the measure of angles are 3x, 5x, 9x, and 13x respectively. Therefore, the four angles of a quadrilateral 360 degree. So all the angles addition. So 3x plus 5x plus 9x plus 13x equal to 360 degree. How much? 8. No? It is 8. Now that one is what? 8. 17. 17 and 13. How much? 13 and 17. 30. 30 degree. No? Now x equal to 360 degrees. X equal to 360 degrees by 30. X equal to how much? 12 degree. X equal to 12 degree. Now x equal to 12 degree means what? So half angle. Half angle equal to how much? 3x means 3 into 12 degree means what? 36. Second angle equal to 5x means 5x means what? 5 into 12 degree equal to 60 degree. And third angle. How much? 9x means 9 into 12 degree equal how much? 12 degree. And fourth angle equals to 13x means 13 into 12 degree means how much? 156 degree. No? Now it is right around, you see here, adding 6, 6, 6, 6, 12. Just to add now here 108, 156, 60, 36. 6, 6, 12, and 20, 0. Then it is 0. Then 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 1 carry, then 3, 360, right. That is the four angles of the quadrilateral. Try to understand all of this one. Read and learn properly. Thank you.